Multiprotocol label switching, that is MPLS, has been around for several years. It is a popular networking technology that uses labels attached to packets to forward them through the network. In this video, we are going to brief about MPLS. The MPLS labels are advertised between routers so that they can build a label-to-label mapping. These labels are attached to the IP packets, enabling the routers to forward the traffic by looking at the label and not the destination IP address. These packets are forwarded by label switching instead of by IP switching. The label switching technique is not new. Frame relay and ATM use it to move frames or cells throughout a network. In frame relay, the frame can be any length, whereas in ATM, a fixed length cell consists of a header of 5 bytes and a payload of 48 bytes. The header of the ATM cell and the frame relay frame refer to the virtual circuit that the cell or frame resides on. The similarity between frame relay and ATM is that at each hop throughout the network, the label value in the header is changed. This is difference from the forwarding of IP packets. When a router forwards an IP packet, it does not change a value that pertains to the destination of the packet. That is, it does not change the destination IP address of the packet. The fact that the MPLS labels are used to forward the packets and no longer the destination IP address have led to the popularity of MPLS. These benefits, such as the better integration of IP over ATM and the popular MPLS virtual private network, that is VPN application. Now let us take a look on pre-MPLS protocols. Before MPLS, the most popular WAN protocols were ATM and frame relay. Cost-effective WAN networks were built to carry various protocols. With the popularity of the internet, IP became the most popular protocol. IP was everywhere. VPN were created over these WAN protocols. Customers leased ATM links and frame relay links, or used leased lines and built their own private network over it. Because of routers of the provider supplied at layer 2 service toward the layer 3 customer routers, the separation and isolation between different customer networks were guaranteed. These kinds of networks are referred to as overlay network. Overlay networks are still used today, but many customers are now using the MPLS VPN service. Conventional routing versus MPLS forwarding mode. First, let us describe how the new paradigm shift might help in improving quality of service performance by comparing conventional routing to the MPLS forwarding mode. In an MPLS environment, conventional layer 3 or network layer routing, that is IP routing, is used to determine a path through the network. After The path is determined. Data packets are then switched through each node as they traverse the network. Conventional routing mode. In a traditional connectionless network, every router runs a layer 3 routing algorithm. As a packet traverses through the network, each router along the path makes an independent forwarding decision for that packet. Using information contained in the packet header as well as information obtained from the routing algorithm, the router chooses a next hop destination for the packet. In an IP network, this process involves matching the destination address stored in the IP header of each packet with the most specific route obtained from the IP routing table. This comparison process determines the next hop destination for the packet. This analysis and classification of the layer 3 header can be processor intensive. In a traditional connectionless environment, this activity occurs at every node along the end-to-end path. MPLS forwarding model. In an MPLS environment, optimum paths through the network are identified in advance. Then, as data packets enter the MPLS network, ingress devices use information in the layer 3 header to assign the packets to one of the predetermined paths. This assignment is used to append a label referencing the end-to-end path into the packet. The label accompanies the data packet as it traverses the network. Subsequent routers along the path use the information in the label to determine the next hop device. Because these devices only manipulate information in the label, processor intensive analysis and classification of the layer 3 header occurs only at the ingress point. Benefits of MPLS. In addition to reducing the processing requirements on devices in the core of the network, MPLS has a number of additional advantages over conventional layer 3 routing. Traffic engineering. Traffic engineering is the process of selecting network paths so that the resulting traffic patterns achieve a balanced utilization of resources. Routing based on conventional interior gateway protocol, that is IGP algorithms, might select network paths that result in unbalanced resource utilization. In these environments, some network resources are overused while others are underused. A limited degree of engineering can be provided by manipulating the IGP metrics associated with network links. However, this effort is difficult to manage in environments with a large number of redundant paths. To achieve the benefits of traffic engineering, MPLS can be used in conjunction with IGP algorithms. MPLS provides the ability to specify the specific route data packets should use to traverse the network. This explicit routing of data packets ensures that a particular stream of data uses a specific path. By monitoring and managing these data streams, efficient utilization of network resources can be achieved. Explicit routing has been available through the source routing option of traditional IP routing. However, because this is a processor intensive activity, its usage has been limited. MPLS makes the efficient use of explicit routing possible. MPLS also provides the ability to analyze fields outside the IP packet header when determining the explicit route for a data packet. For example, the network administrator can develop traffic flow policies based on how or where a packet entered the network. In traditional network, this information is only available at the ingress point. The additional analysis provides the administrator with a higher level of control, resulting in a more predictable level of service. Quality of service routing. Quality of service routing is the ability to choose a route for a particular data stream so that the path provides a desired level of service. These levels of service can specify acceptable levels of bandwidth, delay, or packet loss in the network. This provides the intelligence to deliver different levels of service based on overall network policies. Providing a network path delivering a desired quality of service often requires the use of explicit routing. For example, it is straightforward to allocate a path for a particular stream requiring a specific bandwidth allocation. However, it is possible that the combined bandwidth of multiple streams may exceed existing capacity. In this scenario, individual streams, even those between the same ingress and egress nodes, might need to be individually routed. This requires a finer level of granularity than that provided by standard traffic engineering. There are two approaches to providing quality of service routing in an MPLS environment. One, the MPLS label contains class of service, that is COS information. As traffic flows through the network, this information can be used to intelligently prioritize traffic at each network hop. Second, the MPLS network can provision multiple paths between ingress and egress devices. Each path is engineered to provide a different level of service. Traffic is then intelligently assigned to an appropriate path as it enters the network. These approaches simply classify packets into the class of service category. Local network administration policies determine the service provided to each category. Multiprotocol support. The Multiprotocol Label Switching standard provides support for existing network layer protocols including IPv4, IPv6, IPX, and AppleTalk. The standard also provides link layer support for Ethernet, Token Ring, FDDI, ATM, Frame Relay, and point-to-point links. Please note that MPLS is not limited to a specific link layer technology. It can function on any media over which network layer packets can pass.